my name is Abdul Bondo, and I'm the producer and editor for Sierra Image Films.
Emmanuel Adu
and Kadeem Mansoura.
And we are here at the Sierra Image Film Studio,
highlighting the president's visit to the United States.
At the Sierra Leone Embassy in Washington, D.C.
Hope you enjoy.
The president just arrived.
You see some very familiar faces around. So the format we want to engage, the president has promised that he's going to pay a visit to the United States in the near future. During that time, he will meet with the Sierra Leone community. He will travel around the states and will be able to give you much more time than you have today. What we have done is to invite heads of community groups. So what I will say we do, maybe we start from the land, we just stand up and say your name and you say the community you represent. And then we might get the president to address us. If we have time, maybe we will have one or two people say something, but the time is very limited because he has to be at the hotel where he has interviews with Voice of America, CNN and his other agencies.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Good afternoon.
You have a fantastic reason to be optimistic.
Amen.
You have a beautiful reason to be here. You have a president who, before he came into governance, you allowed him to be your president in 2007. All you heard about development in Sierra Leone was that we were the least developed in the whole world. He took that and turned that into an agenda for change.
Fellow Sierra Leoneans, I am very, very pleased to be here this afternoon, and I am happy that at a very short notice, the ambassador has been quick to rally around a very strong representative group of Sierra Leoneans here this afternoon. I must seize this opportunity to say a big thank you to all of you for participating in the just concluded elections. I must say that I am very impressed that we have this representative group. The composition reflects the thinking that I now have, because for me, the elections are over. For me, it is about Sierra Leone. Moving Sierra Leone forward. I am happy that Sierra Leone is here. All the political parties are here. The elections, like I said, are over. But when I came into governance in 2007, we rolled out the agenda for change. And I'm sure the agenda for change is a program you are all familiar with. In the agenda for change, we made significant progress. But I will be the first person to say that in spite of the progress we made, we still had challenges. We did not get to the point where we wanted to go. But we made progress in the infrastructural development in the country. We made progress in improving electricity generation. We made progress in improving, we made progress in improving agricultural productivity. We made progress in improving on the health service provision. Within it, we introduced the free healthcare for pregnant women, lactating mothers, and children under 5. We are making progress in the reform of the educational sector. We are now spending more money than any other government have spent in the past on education, and we are working on reforming in keeping with the Gbemadja Commission of Inquiry's recommendation on the reform of the education. And we have made progress on improving good governance. Commission has been upgraded to A status in Geneva just recently. The IMC, the Anti-Corruption Commission, and others have continued to enjoy their independence. And my human rights records are impeccable. No journalist. No journalist has been incarcerated. I enjoy the writings in the social media. We have not had any political prisoner. These are all efforts on improving governance in the country. Additionally, we have made a lot of efforts in improving on the business environment to the extent that we have attracted a lot of direct foreign investment in the country that is now impacting on the mining sector, the agricultural sector, and to some extent the tourism. As a result of the efforts that we have made, we have been recognized by the World Bank, the IMF, the Mo Ibrahim Index, the United Nations. As a result of the efforts that we have made, we have been granted compact status by the MCC. That is why we are here. I'm just coming from MCC. And as a result of the efforts that we have made in recognition of these great efforts, I have been invited by the President of America to come and talk about improving cooperation. So these are all great efforts that we have made as a nation. These are efforts that we have made as a government. And in the next few weeks, we are going to launch formally the Agenda for Prosperity. The Agenda for Prosperity will be our roadmap in the next 5 years. We intend to continue with the programs that we have started on infrastructure, energy, agriculture. But we want to lay emphasis on ensuring that we make more Sierra Leoneans benefit from the opportunities that are now opening up in the country. We'll ensure that the youths are empowered with the appropriate skills and expertise. Sierra Leoneans are trained so that when we have the mining industry, the agricultural industry, tourism opening up, Sierra Leoneans will benefit directly. We are also going to focus on empowering women. In the Agenda for Prosperity, most of all of the pillars, we have 8 pillars there, a good number of the pillars, we have mainstreamed the activities of women, and we also have the 8th pillar as a pillar that will empower women, and we are going to focus on that. So these are the programs we have embarked on, and we have embarked on these programs because in the 50th year celebration that we had, I have challenged Sierra Leoneans, and we've challenged ourselves to transform the country to a middle income status in the next 35 years. That is why the next 5 years are going to be very critical. And for me, it is not going to be about APC or SLPP, it is about transforming Sierra Leone. It is about engaging Sierra Leoneans. All of us should remain engaged. I believe when we transform Sierra Leone, everybody will benefit.
Yes.
When we improve on the roads to Koindu, everybody will benefit. When we improve on the healthcare facilities in Koindu, the women out there will benefit. When we improve on education in Bonth, everybody will benefit. So that is going to be our direction. So coming out here with a very limited time, I would want to assure all of you that we are going to move on. I have made a commitment that yes, we made some progress in the agenda for change, but I have made a commitment that I will do more. I have made a commitment. I have made a commitment that with you, all of us will do more to transform Sierra Leone. The time we have is limited. The time I have is limited. After 2017, I'll step aside. But before 2017, I want to ensure that I work on my legacy.
Good. Yes.
And I look forward to your support, your collaboration, so that together my legacy will lay the basis of a Sierra Leone that will have a growth that is sustainable. There will be no reversals.
Exactly.
I know that the expectations are high.
Indeed.
Expectations in terms of performance, expectations in terms of productivity, and expectations in terms of jobs. A good number of Sierra Leoneans want to go back home. Yeah. Where are the jobs?
Yeah.
These are great expectations.
That's why I'm here.
But we, with a commitment by all of us working together, we will get over that hurdle. We have to take complete control of running Sierra Leone. And with the numbers that we have, the opportunities that we have, the potential out there, I am sure very soon we will provide answers and positive answers to all of the questions that you are raising. So let me conclude by saying that you have a commitment that I will do more. When I come for the UN meeting, I will spend more time with you and we will engage better, so that by which time you will understand the details of the agenda for prosperity. For now, let me thank you, and let me thank you for the Sierra Leoneanness that I have seen today. All of us here representing Sierra Leone, working as Sierra Leoneans, and let us stay as Sierra Leoneans. Thank you very much.
Thank you.